Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject fluid mechanics and machines. This is lecture number 6.3. We are going to solve problems in the viscous fluid flow or laminar fluid flow. In the earlier two lectures on the viscous fluid flow or laminar fluid flow, we discussed about the viscous flow, Reynolds number, laminar flow through circular pipe, laminar flow between parallel plates, Cauchy flow, power loss due to viscous resistance in journal bearing, footstep bearing and the collar bearing. So these are all the theoretical topics we discussed in the earlier two lectures, and in this lecture we are going to solve problems in the viscous flow or laminar flow from the Anna University question papers. Example number 1. From May 2006 question paper, oil of absolute viscosity 1.5 poise and density 850 kg per meter cube flows through a 30 cm internal diameter pipe. The head loss in 3000 meter length pipe is 20 meter. Assuming laminar flow, find the average velocity, Reynolds number and the fanning friction factor. So the given parameters: dynamic viscosity or absolute viscosity, mu equal to 1.5 poise, which is 0.15 newton second per meter square. Rho, density equal to 850 kg per meter cube. Head loss equal to 20 meter and length of the pipe is 3000 meter and the diameter of the pipe is 0.3 meters. From the Hagen-Poiseuille's equation, the average velocity, we calculate the average velocity. HF equal to the Hagen-Poiseuille equation, HF equal to 32 mu L U divided by rho g d square. So from this equation, rearranging, we calculate u. U equal to hf into rho g d square divided by 32 mu into l. So substituting 20 into 850 into 9.81 into 0.3 square divided by 32 into 0.15 into 3000 equal to 1.04 meters per second. Now we calculate the Reynolds number. Re equal to rho u d divided by mu. 850 into 1.04 into 0.3 divided by 0.15 equal to 1768. So the Reynolds number is less than 2300. The flow is laminar. Now the fanning friction factor, F equal to 16 by Reynolds number. So 16 divided by 1768 equal to 9.05 in 10 power minus 3. So the answer to the problem, the average velocity is 1.04 meters per second. Reynolds number is 1768. And the fanning friction factor is 9.05 10 power minus 3. Example number 2 from November 2009 question paper. The diameters of a pipe at section 1-1 and 2-2 are 100 mm and 50 mm respectively. If the discharge through the pipe is 0.008 cubic meter per second, find the average velocities at the two sections. So we are given diameter D1 at the section 1 equal to 0.1 meter. Diameter D2 at section 2 equal to 0.05 meter and discharge Q equal to 0.008 meter cube per second. We calculate the area of the pipe at the section inlet section 1-1 and outlet section 2-2. A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square. So 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.1 square equal to 0.00785 meter square. And A2 equal to pi by 4 D2 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.05 square equal to 0.00196 meter square. Then we calculate the velocity at the inlet and the outlet. V1 equal to Q by A1, which is 0.008 divided by 0.00785 equal to 1.02 meters per second. And the V2 velocity at the outlet, Q by A2, which is 0.008 divided by 0.00196 equal to 4.08 meters per second. The answer to the problem, velocity at section 1-1 equal to 1.02 meter, velocity at section 2-2 equal to 4.08 meters per second. Example number 3 from November 2010 question paper. An oil of viscosity 0.9 Pascal second and density 900 kg per meter cube flows through a pipe of 100 mm diameter. The rate of pressure drop for every meter length of the pipe is 25 kPa. Find the oil flow rate, drag force per meter length, pumping power required to maintain the flow over a distance of 1 km, velocity and the shear stress at 15 mm from the pipe wall. So we are given mu equal to 0.9 Pascal second, rho density equal to 900 kg per meter cube, diameter equal to 0.1 meter and the pressure drop minus dp by dx pressure drop, it is given as 25 kilopascal per meter length. So minus dp by dx is equal to 25 kilopascal per meter length. And we calculate the area of the pipe. A equal to pi by 4 d square, 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.1 square equal to 0.00785 meter square. From the Hagen-Poiseuille's equation, we calculate the average velocity. Pressure drop delta P equal to 32 mu L U divided by D square. So from this equation, velocity U equal to average velocity U equal to delta P into D square divided by 32 mu L. So which is 25 into 1000 into 0.1 square divided by 32 into 0.9 into 1. So this 1000, 25 into 1000 to convert the pressure drop into Pascal. So 25,000 Pascal per meter length. So the velocity equal to 8.68 meters per second. Then discharge through the pipe, Q equal to U into A. So U equal to 8.68 and area equal to 0.00785 equal to 0.068 meter cube per second. And the wall shear stress, tau O equal to minus dp by dx into r by 2. So minus dp by dx equal to 25,000 into r equal to 0.05 divided by 2. We are given diameter is 0.1 meter. So radius equal to 0.05 divided by 2. So which is 625 newtons per meter square. Drag force per meter length of the pipe. Fd equal to the wall shear stress into the area. Pi d into L. So 625 into 3.14 into 0.1. Into 1 meter. So per meter length, we have to calculate per meter length. So L equal to 1 meter. So which is 196.25 newton. And the pumping power required to for a distance of 1 kilometer. So pumping power P equal to discharge into delta P. So discharge is 0.068. Earlier we calculated delta P equal to 25 kilopascal. And meter length, 1 kilometer length, 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meter. So multiplying by 1000 meter, it is 1700 kilowatt or 1.7 megawatt. The pumping power required is 1.7 megawatt. The velocity and the shear stress at 15 millimeter from the pipe wall. So the radius we have to calculate. We are given the distance from the surface of the pipe wall. Pipe wall, the length is Y. So R equal to capital R minus Y. So capital R is the outer radius. Y is the distance from the wall, so 0.05 minus 0.015 equal to 0.035 meter. So this is the radius at which we have to calculate the velocity and the shear stress. So velocity and the shear stress, U equal to minus 1 by 4 mu dp by ds into capital R square minus small r square. So 1 by 4 into mu, 4 into 0.9 minus of dp by ds equal to 25,000. So the pressure drop per meter length is minus 25,000. Into 0.05 square minus 0.035 square equal to 8.85 meters per second. So the velocity at a distance of, at a radius of 0.035 meters square equal, 35 meter is 8.85 meters per second. And the shear stress at this radius, shear stress equal to tau O into small r by capital R. So 625 into 0.035 divided by 0.05 equal to 437.5 newtons per meter square. So the answers to the problem, oil flow rate 0.068 meter cube per second, drag force per meter length 196.25 newton, pumping power required to maintain the flow over a distance of 1 kilometer, 1.7 megawatts, velocity and the shear stress at the 15 millimeter from the pipe wall, which is 8.85 meters per second and 435.5 newtons per meter square. Example number 4. From November 2010 question paper, an oil of specific gravity 0.82, kinematic viscosity 16 into 10 power minus 6 meter square per second, flows in a smooth pipe of 8 centimeter diameter at a rate of 2 LPS. Determine whether the flow is laminar or turbulent. Also calculate velocity at the center line and the velocity at a radius of 2.5 centimeter. What is the head loss for a length of 10 meter? What will be the entry length? Also determine the wall shear stress. So we are given specific gravity equal to 0.82, so density equal to 820. So 0.82 into 1000, that is what the density of the fluid, so 820 kilogram per meter cube. Kinematic viscosity nu equal to 16 into 10 power minus 6 meter square per second. Diameter equal to 0.08 meter. Discharge equal to 2 LPS. Radius small r equal to 0.025 meter. And length of the pipe is 10 meter. we calculate the area of the pipe, A equal to pi by 4 d square. So 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.08 square equal to 5.024 into 10 power minus 3 meter square. And we calculate the average velocity, u equal to discharge divided by the area. So 2 into 10 power minus 3 divided by 5.024 into 10 power minus 3. So 2 LPS to convert liters into meter cube, we have to multiply by 10 power minus 3. So 0.4 meters per second. Velocity is 0.4 meters per second. Then a Reynolds number, Re equal to ud divided by nu, kinematic viscosity. So 0.4 into 0.08 divided by 16 into 10 power minus 6 equal to 2000. So the Reynolds number is less than 2300. The flow is laminar. So the dynamic viscosity mu equal to nu into rho, kinematic viscosity into density. So 16 into 10 power 6 into 820 equal to 0.013 Newton second by meter square. Then we calculate the velocity at the center line, u max equal to 2 times of u, which is 2 into 0.4 equal to 0.8 meters per second. Then pressure gradient we calculate, u equal to minus 1 by 8 mu dp by dx into r square. So this is the equation available in the theory part. So from this equation we calculate the pressure gradient minus dp by dx. So minus dp by dx equal to 8 mu u divided by r square. So substituting 8 into 0.013 into 0.4 divided by 0.04 square equal to 26 newtons per meter square. So the pressure gradient is 26 meters newtons per meter square. Then we calculate the velocity at a distance of 0.025 meter. So u equal to minus 4 mu into dp by dx into capital R square minus small r square. So 1 by 4 into 0.013, mu equal to 0.013 minus dp by dx equal to 26. Already we have calculated. So 26 into 0.04 square minus 0.025 square equal to 0.4875 meters per second. The head loss for a length of 10 meter, HF equal to 32 mu UL divided by rho g d square, substituting 32 into 0.013 into 0.4 into 10 divided by 820 into 9.81 into 0.08 square equal to 0.032 meter. Entry length LH equal to 0.056 Reynolds number into diameter. So these are all the equations available in the theory part. So entry length LH equal to 0.056 into 2000 into 0.08 equal to 8.96 meter. Next we calculate the wall shear stress, tau o equal to minus dp by dx into r by 2. So it is equal to 26 minus dp by dx equal to 26. 26 into 0.04 divided by 2 equal to 0.52 newtons per meter square. So the answer to the problem, velocity at the center line 0.8 meters per second, velocity at the radius 2.5 centimeter 0.04875 meters per second, head loss for a length of 10 meter 0.032 meter, entry length is 8.96 meter and wall shear stress is 0.52 newtons per meter square. Example number 5 from November 2011 question paper. Lubricating oil at a velocity of 1 meters per second average flows through a pipeline of 100 millimeter in inlet diameter. Determine whether the flow is laminar or turbulent. Also determine the friction factor and the pressure drop over 10 meter length. What should be the velocity for the flow to turn to turbulent? Density is 930 kg per meter cube. Dynamic viscosity is 0.1 newton seconds per meter square. So u is given as 1 meters per second, diameter equal to 0.1 meter, length equal to 10 meter, rho density equal to 930 kg per meter cube, and absolute viscosity, dynamic viscosity or absolute viscosity, mu equal to 0.1 newton second by meter square. So we calculate the Reynolds number. Reynolds number equal to rho ud divided by mu, 930 into 1 into 0.1 divided by 0.1 equal to 930. So the Reynolds number is less than 2300. The flow is laminar. So for the laminar flow, the fanning friction F equal to 16 by Reynolds number, 16 by 930 equal to 0.0172. Then pressure drop for a length of 10 meter, delta P equal to 32 mu UL divided by D square. So 32 into 0.1 into 1 into 10 divided by 0.1 square equal to 3200 newtons per meter square. And velocity for the flow to become turbulent. So U equal to Reynolds number into mu divided by rho D. So Reynolds number, if the Reynolds number is greater than 2300, the flow will become turbulent. I take RE equal to 2300 into 0.1 divided by 930 into 0.1 equal to 2.47 meters per second. So if the velocity is greater than 2.47 meters per second, the flow will become turbulent. So the answer to the problem, friction factor is 0.0172, pressure drop over 10 meter length equal to 3200 newtons per meter square. The velocity for the flow to turn to turbulent is 2.47 meters per second. Example number 6 from November 2014 question paper. An oil of specific gravity 0.8 and kinematic viscosity 15 into 10 power minus 6 meter square per second flows in a smooth pipe of 12 centimeter diameter at a rate of 150 liters per minute. Determine whether the flow is laminar or turbulent. Also calculate the velocity at the center line and velocity at a radius of 4 cm. What is the head loss for a length of 10 meter? What will be the entry length? Also determine the wall shear stress. Specific gravity is 0.8. So density equal to 800 kg per meter cube. Kinematic viscosity is 15 into 10 power minus 6 meter square per second. Diameter equal to 0.12 meter. Discharge equal to 150 lpm liters per minute, which is 2.5 liters per second. Radius equal to, r is smaller equal to 0.04 meter and the length equal to 10 meter. We calculate the area of the pipe. Area equal to pi by 4 d square. So 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.12 square equal to 0.0113 meter square. And average velocity u equal to q by a, which is 2.5 10 power minus 3 divided by 0.0113 equal to 0.22 meters per second. And Reynolds number, Re equal to ud by nu, so 0.22 into 0.12 divided by 15 into 10 power minus 6 equal to 1760. So Reynolds number is less than 2300, the flow is laminar. Then we calculate the dynamic viscosity, mu equal to nu into rho, kinematic viscosity into density. So 15 into 10 power minus 6 into 800 equal to 0.012 newton second by meter square. So the velocity at the center line, u max equal to 2 into u. So 2 into 0.22 equal to 0.44 meters per second. And the pressure gradient we calculate from the equation u equal to minus 1 by 8 mu dp by dx into r square. Now the pressure gradient is minus dp by dx, which is 8 into mu into u divided by r square. So 8 into 0.012 into 0.22 divided by 0.06 square equal to 5.87 newton per meter square. Then we calculate the velocity at a radius of 0.04 meter. So mu u equal to minus 1 by 4 mu dp by dx into capital R square minus small r square. Capital R is the outer radius. R is the radius, given radius. So u equal to 1 by 4 into 0.012. Mu equal to 0.012 minus dp by dx equal to 5.87 into 0.06 square minus 0.04 square equal to 0.245 meters per second. Then head loss for a length of 10 meter, HF equal to 32 mu UL divided by rho g d square. So 32 into 0.012 into 0.22 into 10 divided by 800 into 9.81 into 0.12 square equal to 7.47 10 power minus 3 meter. And the entry length LH equal to 0.056 into Reynolds number into diameter, which is 0.056 into 1760 into 0.12, which is 11.83 meter. And the wall shear stress, tau o equal to minus dp by dx into r by 2. So 5.8, so minus dp by dx equal to 5.87 into 0.06 divided by 2 equal to 0.176 newtons per meter square. The answer to the problem, velocity at the center line 0.44 meters per second, velocity at the radius 4 centimeter 0.245 meters per second, head loss for a length of 10 meter 7.47 10 power minus 3 meter, entry length 11.83 meter, wall shear stress 0.176 newtons per meter square. Example number 7 from November 2009 question paper. The fixed wall, fixed panel plates kept at 80 millimeter apart having laminar flow of oil between them with a maximum velocity of 1.5 meters per second. Taking dynamic viscosity of the oil to be 19.62 poise, calculate discharge per meter width, shear stress of the plate, the pressure difference between two points 25 mm apart, velocity at 20 mm from the plate and the velocity gradient at the plate end. So you are given thickness, the gap between the plate thickness, that is thickness equal to 0.08 meter, The maximum velocity is 1.5 meters per second. Mu 19.62, dynamic viscosity is 19.62 poise, which is 1.962 Newton second per meter square. We calculate the average velocity. Average velocity is 0.667 U max for the flow between parallel plate. U equal to 0.667 U max, which is 0.667 into 1.5 equal to 1 meters per second. Then the discharge per meter length. So Q equal to U into area. So area between parallel plate. T into B. So T is the height between the plate and B is the width of the plate. So U into T into B, 1 into 0.08 into 1 equal to 0.08 meter cube per second. Then the shear stress at the plate. So minus dp by dx equal to 8 mu U max by T square. First we calculate the pressure gradient. So 8 into 1.96 into 1.5 divided by 0.08 square equal to 3678.75 newtons per meter square. And here we calculate wall shear stress tau o equal to minus dp by dx into t by 2. So 3678.75 into 0.08 divided by 2 equal to 147.15 newtons per meter square. The pressure difference between the two points 25 millimeter apart, minus dp by dx equal to minus half p2 minus p1 divided by x2 minus x1. So to remove the negative sign, I change the direction p1 minus p2 divided by x2 minus x1. So delta P divided by X2 minus X1. So the X2 minus X1 equal to length which is 25 millimeter. So delta P divided by L. So delta P equal to minus dp by dx into L, which is 3678.75 into 0.025 equal to 91.97 newtons per meter square. The velocity at 20 millimeter from the plate. So U equal to minus 1 by 2 mu dp by dx into ty minus y square. So minus dp by dx equal to 3678.75 1 by 2 into 1.962 into 3678.75 into 0.08 into 0.02 minus 0.02 square equal to 1.125 meters per second. And the velocity gradient at the plate end du by dx at y equal to 0, so which is tau o divided by mu 147.15 divided by 1.962 equal to 75 seconds to the power minus 1. So the answer to the problem, the discharge per meter width 0.08 meter cube per second, the shear stress at the plate 147.15 newtons per meter square, the pressure difference between the two points 25 millimeter apart 91.97 newtons per meter square, the velocity at 20 millimeter from the plate 1.125 meters per second, the velocity gradient at the end of the plate 75 seconds to the power minus 1. Example number 8 from November 2019 question paper. A laminar flow is taking place in a pipe of diameter 200 mm. The maximum velocity is 1.5 meters per second. Find the mean velocity and radius at which this occurs. Also calculate the velocity at 4 cm from the wall of the pipe. So we write down the given data. Diameter equal to 0.2 meter. Maximum velocity is 1.5 meters per second. Y equal to 0.04 meter. Mean velocity or average velocity is small u equal to u max divided by 2. So 1.5 divided by 2 equal to 0.75 meters per second. So u max equal to minus 1 by 4 mu dp by dx into r square. So rearranging, we calculate 1 by mu dp by dx equal to 4 u max divided by r square, which is 4 into 1.5 divided by 0.1 square equal to 600. So from the given maximum velocity, we calculate the parameter minus 1 by mu dp by dx, which is 600. Now the radius at which the mean velocity occurs. So u equal to minus 1 by 4 mu dp by dx into capital R square minus small r square. So here we have calculated 1 by mu dp by dx. So in the earlier 1 by mu dp by dx equal to 600. So 1 by mu dp by dx equal to 600. 1 by 4 into 600 into 0.1 square minus r square. So u equal to 0.75. So calculating the radius equal to 0.071 meter. The velocity at the 4 cm from the pipe wall. So small r equal to r minus y. So 0.1 divided by 0.04 equal to 0.06 meter. So what is given is 4 cm is y. The value y from the surface of the pipe wall. So radius at which we have to calculate the velocity is 0.06 meter. So small r equal to 0.06 meter. Now u equal to minus 1 by 4 mu dp by dx r square minus small r square. So it is 1 by 4 into 600 into 0.1 square minus 0.6 square equal to 0.96 meters per second. The answer to the problem, the mean velocity and radius at which this occurs are 0.75 meters per second and r equal to 0.071 meter. The velocity at the 4 centimeter from the pipe wall equal to 0.96 meters per second. So we stop here. So these are the books I have written in mechanical engineering. So you may find fluid mechanics in machines. So you can refer to the book for additional problems in the laminar flow. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel and use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. If you have any queries, you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number. So we'll meet again with another video lectures on the fluid mechanics in machines. Until then, bye bye.